Of the Whisky Hunter. Hey, Jamie. Jason. Hey, Michael. Mariah. How's everybody feeling? It's Friday night. We're gonna try three great whiskeys tonight. I'm gonna try three great whiskeys tonight. This bottle of Glenfiddich Bourbon Barrel Reserve. This bottle of the Balvenie Kirby Cask. This bottle of Monkey Shoulder Blend. It's gonna be great. Arianna, Danielle. Rami, how's everyone doing? Got a drink. You don't have to drink whiskey, but over here drinking and packing. It's all right. You don't have to drink whiskey, but you should be drinking whiskey because it's Friday. All right. Because I'm the whiskey, a whiskey, a whiskey, a whiskey hunter. Steph, and Layla, Nancy, how's everyone doing? Friday night, episode 5, still no babies. That's why I'm here, still allowed to be here. Loving the theme song. Thank you very much. So we're gonna get right to work, folks. Last week, I went overtime. I was about 48 minutes, got some heat from the producers. I tune in for the theme. Then he tunes in for the theme and then he leaves. Don't leave. Oh, and the whiskey. Good. Hey, Gloria. So, like I said, I think I said in the intro, we're going back to Scotland this week. Great. I'm going to be on the phone to Scotland after this, Michael. We went back to Scotland this week, went to the region called SPEYSIDE, cousin Andrew, David, and tried three great whiskeys from SPEYSIDE. I think they're all actually from the same town, Dufftown. We got the Glenfiddich here, we have a Balvenie, and we have a blend called Monkey Shoulder. So I'm going to get right to work. I hope you're pouring your drinks. I hope you're having your whiskeys at home. I hope maybe some people saw some posts during the week and they went out and bought one or all of these whiskeys. That'd be the smart thing to do, but you don't have to do that. So we're going to get to work right away on this beautiful bottle of Glenfiddich. Glenfiddich 14 Bourbon Barrel Reserve. First of all, badass looking bottle. Glenfiddichs kind of always look sexy with this sleek shape, but the blue is something new. Taylor, how's it going? How's everyone doing? While I'm talking, I'm gonna pour myself a drink because I haven't had a drink in a little bit. Mariah, Steph, yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. Steph, I hope you're smoking a cigar. So, a little bit of history, Glenfiddich. Obviously, this Bourbon Barrel Reserve comes from the Glenfiddich Distillery. The distillery owned and started by William Grant & Sons, Denise, Brady. William Grant & Sons started the distillery in 1887 William started the distillery with his sons. Well, actually with his kids. Nine kids. So him and his nine kids built the distillery by hand. It's pretty crazy. 1887, they built a distillery. Carly, Melanie, built the distillery by hand. I don't know what's crazier, building a distillery by hand in 1887 or having nine kids in 1887. Hey, Bri, how's it going? So the Glenfiddich distillery has been around forever. They're an institution in whiskey around the world, one of the biggest whiskeys around the world. But this this Bourbon Barrel Reserve is new. Maybe it came out last year, in the last couple years for sure. Maybe it was just last year. Michelle, Waleed, Melanie, how's everyone doing? Okay, so back to work. I'm gonna try and stay focused this week. I was rambling like a crazy person last week. So Bourbon Barrel Reserve, 14 years. So just to get a little bit technical for a second, if I get boring, I'll just stop talking. Just yell at me, tell me to stop. So 14 years, it's aged, okay? Like most whiskeys, ex-bourbon, American oak casks, it's aged for 14 years. After the 14 years, hey Bev, Robbie, after the 14 years, it's taken out of those barrels and it's put into new American oak barrels, which they have like a deeper char on them. So they're put into brand new, deeply charred oak barrels and they're finished in those new barrels. I did my research. I don't know how long they're finished in those barrels for, but if anyone knows, any whiskey experts out there, if they know, chuck the answer up there or you could let me know after. All I know is it makes this beautiful whiskey and we're gonna try it right now. So cheers to anyone who's got the same whiskey at home. If you don't, that's fine. But if you're drinking anything, hey Chad, cheers to Friday night, the Whisky Hunter, episode 5. Still haven't got fired yet. Cheers everybody. So let's have a little snifter first before we dive in. Zim zimma. Okay, so right away I'm getting those like a deep wood oak kind of smell. I mean, matured in oak cast for 14 years and then refinished in new oak cast. So hey Chad. All right, man. Now that I said the word oak, I can smell the oak for sure. Some vanilla notes. I'm gonna go in and have a sip. Hey Woods, Dustin, cheers everyone. Sociable. You don't want to chug these back too quick. I like to let them sit on my palate for a little bit. Oh man. Woo-wee. Nice and warm. Stays nice and warm on the palate. Like the whole, everything warm. Tongue, mouth, lips, teeth. 4 to 6 months. No, I think that was the, I think that's the other one. So we got some, we got the spice. I mean, this kind of ode to bourbon is, I mean, you get the bourbon, the hit of bourbon right away, the spiciness, the warmth, the woodiness. Very bourbon-esque on the finish. Snifter, yep. Larry Ash, savor it, yes. Trying to savor it, it's difficult. It's difficult on a Friday. Savor them, folks. Oh, nice long finish. And the heat doesn't go away. Woodiness, there's a woodiness to it, Woody. Absolutely. There's definitely a woodiness to it. And the heat, oh man, it's just like a, I mean, it's my first drink of the night, but it's just like a warm American / Scottish hug, full body hug. It's great. They say, well, I've seen it written that the Glenfiddich Bourbon Barrel Reserve, it's born in Scotland, but it's got an American accent. So that kind of explains, it's a single malt, but it's got that bourbon American flavor to it. If you're a bourbon drinker and you want to get into single malts and your single malts are too powerful for you, this is like a gateway whiskey. That makes sense? In a good way, a gateway in a good way. Cheers, folks. Oh, baby, that's a beaut. That's a beaut. I dig all three of these whiskeys actually, but that's a beaut. Frye, cheers. Cheers, man. Cheers, everyone. So this Glenfiddich's kind of ode to America, American bourbon, I'm going to do an old American song for you, but I must warn you, it's one of those songs where you have to concentrate really hard. Checking the time. Concentrate really hard, and if something screws up, the whole thing blows up, so let's just hope that that doesn't happen. Don't listen too carefully. Sip your whiskey, talk amongst yourselves, pour yourself another drink, get ready for the next drink. I'm gonna do some sipping music for you. I did my best. That's a tricky, tricky, tricky. Jamie! Tricky song. Lord knows why I tried to play that song. That's an oldie but a goodie. I'd say it's just an oldie. But you know what? Sometimes you gotta just go for it, folks. It's Friday night. Anyways, back to business. I just saw my friend Jamie Johnson. Her handle is at Bourbon Thing. She's on, she's on Twitter, she's on Instagram, at Bourbon Thing, and she's, those of you who tuned in during the week, she's the brand ambassador for the Balvenie, which is my next whiskey, pop, and she did a little live thing with me today and helped me out, and she's been helping me out whiskey-wise since I met her, so props to Jamie, at Bourbon Thing, go, hi, go find her and add her, folks, and ask her serious whiskey questions. If you have not that serious, kind of basic whiskey questions, you can come ask me. But if you got real questions, go talk to her. So moving on to the Balvenie, the Caribbean cask. So there is a kind of connection between these two bottles, the Glenfiddich, aged 14 years, and then finished in different casks. The Balvenie is also aged 14 years, and then it's finished in different casks. So we're gonna get to that one. I'm gonna pour one. Hope everyone's drinking and pouring, sipping. Roland, I don't got any Jack Daniels, man, but if I had some, I would do a shot with you. Speaking of Jamie, I talked to her. She's a professional whiskeyist, and she said to not pour these too big. I get carried away sometimes and I just start pouring them, and then you finish sampling one of them and you're pretty much finished, so I gotta stop doing that. Nancy, oh wow, old school. Roy, cheers everybody. So we're trying the Balvenie Caribbean cask here, okay? So let me try to get technical here, a little bit of pressure because the brand ambassador for Balvenie is watching. But I did my research and I was listening. Steph, I wish you were here too, man. We would be smoking cigars. Doing great, okay, I'm doing okay. So it's aged 14 years. After being aged 14 years, they take it out. The malt master, Jamie told me his name, David Stewart is the malt master at the Balvenie. They're gonna finish this 14-year-old Balvenie in Caribbean casks. So what that means, at the distillery, they get their casks and they season them with selected Caribbean rums. No pressure. Yeah, but correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, so they season them, they season the new casks with David Stewart, the malt master, would select these Caribbean rums, season it till the wood gets nice and soaked in rum, get rid of the rum, and then they put the Balvenie, put the Balvenie back into these casks, and they finish it. It's not getting aged there, it's getting finished there. She told me, I don't know if this is a secret, she told me approximately 4 to 6 months they're finished in these rum casks. So, is that right? Felt good, I don't know if it was right. So I was just about to drink it. Too much pressure! So let's have a sniff of this Balvenie Caribbean cask, okay? Man, it's just amazing how these are so different, correct? Okay, hey Josh. They all kind of look the same when you look at the colors to me, but just amazing the different nose you get on them, the different taste you get in your mouth, the different finishes they have. Every week and every time I'm sampling whiskeys, it just kind of blows me away. So this one right away, I'm getting like a sweeter, almost like a brown sugar, almost like baking, some vanilla, like a hint of spice, but a lot of sweetness again. I'm gonna go in for a sip. Cheers. Cheers, everyone. Hope everyone's drinking some whiskey at home. Wow. So not just because Jamie's watching and she's the brand ambassador for Balvenie, but as you can see by the dent in this bottle, this is one of my favorite whiskeys out there right now. Cheers, everyone. You got, it is a bit pricey, but you gotta get one of these because you gotta get both of these, the Glenfiddich, the Bourbon Barrel Reserve, and the Balvenie. That, like I said, but this one, these are kind of both gateway whiskeys, I think. If you're more of a American whiskey drinker, bourbon drinker, these are gonna get you more into the single malt world. But this one, I'm getting like, it's very, very bourbon-esque. Fireball and Glenlivet, they both work, yes. And the finish, different than the Glenfiddich. It's like, I wouldn't say it's as long as the Glenfiddich, but it's like, it's there, it's kind of lingering. It's like, it's just long enough. Also getting like a hint of, yes, agreed, perfect door to walk through, yes. Aberfeedy. Hi, Sarah. Hi, everybody. this is a great whiskey, folks. Like a little kiss of vanilla right at the end, a little pinch of vanilla. Soft, smooth, spicy, sweet. Oh, smooth or a punch in the face. It's not a punch in the face, Chris. Definitely not. It's very smooth. Very smooth, unlike the delivery of that last song I played. Kiss of Vanilla. Yeah, right at the end, little hint of vanilla. So we're gonna move on, folks. That's two whiskeys. This is a beaut, and it's almost done. Some tears will be shed when this one disappears, probably maybe tonight. But this is a must-have. To be honest, I haven't tried too many of the Balvenies, but this one, this Caribbean cask, is a must-have. I'm gonna have a... You got questions. Jamie's getting questions. I'm gonna move on. I'm gonna do a song for my mom if she's still watching. Margs, you there? My mother always requests this song. I don't know why. I'm gonna try it anyways. This is an old Hank Williams number. Hope everyone's doing good. Folks, already I'm just on time. I'm doing good for time. A little sip of water because I'm parched. Thank you, folks. Hank Williams. Moving on to my last whiskey. I don't mean to keep on talking about Jamie, but she's still here. She recommended I grab this bottle from the liquor store, which I did. I was dressed up like I was gonna rob the place, but I managed to sneak in and I bought this. My wife is still watching. My wife was at the hospital today for 5 hours getting a non-stress test on the babies, and the babies are not stressed. Just for people who care about the babies are fine. 36 weeks pregnant today, and the babies are two little spazzes. I don't know where they get it from, but they couldn't even get their heartbeats because they were just freaking out. The nurse says that one of them or both of them might turn out to be dancers. That's okay with me. Okay. Yay. Yeah. Monkey Shoulder, our last whiskey of the night. And if Jamie's still there, I'm gonna try to explain this one and the vatting and the blending because it's a little bit tricky, but I'm gonna do my best. First of all, the name. I was listening when we talked about the name, but I am Christian. Christian, how you doing? Amal is a rock star. Yes, Amal is a rock star. She's upstairs. She told me tonight, she's like, I don't think I can watch. I can't stay awake. And she's still awake. So the name Monkey Shoulder is kind of like a throwback to centuries ago, whiskey distilling centuries ago. Correct me if I'm wrong. You're doing great. Okay. So the malt men, malt people way back in the day would turn the malted barley with their hands, with a shovel. And due to like a constant repetitive motion of working hours and hours and hours, turning the malted barley, they would get injuries in their shoulder. It would be commonly known as monkey shoulder. And that's where the name for this beautiful bottle came from. And it's cute too. It's got three monkeys. I love the number three. Three monkeys right in the front there. Cool, eh? Yeah, good story. Again, thanks to Jamie for sharing that one with me. So I'm gonna pour this out and try to explain. Oof, careful. Yes, correct, repetitive stress injury, the monkey shoulder, got it. I'm pretty much nailing it today. I'm nailing the knowledge and not nailing the piano playing, but I don't care, because it's Friday. So, how they made this one. All these whiskeys are from SPEYSIDE, which is a region in Scotland. I'm going for some water. Struggling, folks. Struggling. Struggle is real. I'm also symbiotically connected to my wife, so I am also 36 weeks pregnant. Remember that. For all the men out there, I know my wife is going through all the physicalness of being pregnant, but I'm also pregnant. I'm 36 weeks pregnant, trying to learn these songs on piano. Think about that, folks. Think about that. So like I said, this is a blend. This is not a blend. This is a blend. It's a blend of three single malts. Three single malts from SPEYSIDE. Before I talked to Jamie, I did my research and I thought that the blend was actually Glenfiddich, Balvenie, and Caninvi, a different whiskey. She told me I was wrong. And then things got a bit weird and she said the Balvenie's not involved and then she got all quiet. So I think it's a secret. And I'm not going to say anymore. We don't know what's in this. I think if you try to ask her, she's going to block you on Instagram because I think it's a secret that no one can know. But we could try to figure it out just by getting our snifters in there and having a taste. Yes, it is a secret. It used to be. Okay, so anyways, they get these three single malts from SPEYSIDE. And Jamie, if you're there, you can answer this question. They get the three malts. Do they put the three malts together and then they age them for 6 to 8 years? Or are they separate and they're aging on their own for 6 to 8 years? That's the thing that I'm confused about. Wisers, Chad, that's great. This is interesting. She might not get back to me, but either way, the three single malts are aged for 6 to 8 years. Then the master distiller, not 68 years, James, you jerk. 6 to 8, like 6 or 7 or 8, 6 to 8, not 68. Okay, so I was right. And then they're blended, okay? So those three single malts are blended. Everyone following? This is important stuff. Then the master blender would come in and, like it says on the bottle here, batch 27, he hand selects 27 casks. He hand selects 27 casks and he uses those and he matures them until they're ready. Puts them together, matures them until they're ready, until they got the taste of monkey shoulder. That makes sense? 6 to 8 years fully aged and then blended. Yeah, so I was right. Okay, so they're all 6 to 8 years fully aged and then he puts them together and they're blended together until the master blender five times fast. So I was kind of right. You are right. I was right. Like I said, Jamie turned me on to this whiskey. It's a great whiskey. Another thing she told me about, this is, and I actually did some more research on, this is a great whiskey for mixing drinks. If you're into fancy cocktails that involve whiskey, I'm not, only because I don't know how to make any of them. If you're into making them and you want to deliver them to my house, that's fine, that's cool. Or if you want to give me recipes, but it's great. It's like one of the up and coming hot whiskeys out there for mixed drinks. But I don't mind it as a drink, nice and neat. I'm sure it's good on, hey Lee, old school. I'm sure it's good on ice also. So I'm gonna go in for a sniff. Cheers, everyone. Last whiskey. I'm gonna get cut off soon, so I gotta speed things up. Whiskey sours. So it's a blended scotch. Yes, Chris. And then I lost you. Cheers, folks. Let's have a sniff. Hot whiskey. So I always get vanilla. I don't know why I get that. I think it's just because I've read so much that so many whiskeys have vanilla in them that vanilla always comes up in my mind. I get a little bit of a fruit, like an orangey, citrusy zest. This could be wrong, but I'm getting like a popcorn vibe, like a hint of popcorn. I'm going for a sip. Cheers, everyone. Last whiskey. Wow. Very woody. Vanilla's from American Coke. Oh, American Oak, all right. American Coke. Not American Coke, folks. American Oak. I find it kind of creamy. A little bit of, like, it's woody, spicy. Woody, are you still there? I find a little bit of, like, it's got a creamy almost texture to it. Love this whiskey. Love all three of these whiskeys. Not just because the brand ambassador of Canada for Balvenie is watching, but the Balvenie is my favorite, folks. Save up your unemployment checks and go grab a bottle of that. Wood, you still there? Because this is very woody. Yeah, woody is good. On the finish, it's kind of like... dried fruits, maybe. Still got the wood, man. Oh, I really love this. I really love the monkey shoulder. And this is very affordable, folks. A friend, Mariah, if she's still there, I told her to go out and grab one of these two bottles today. And I should have just told her to grab this one because she could have bought four of these. just joking. But this is great. And if anyone gets to get one of these and making some mixed cocktails, let me know because I'm sure those and Lagavulin. Greetings. Django. Love the monkey. Yeah. Are you making this up as you go along? James, I'm ignoring all your comments. So, folks, it's come to that time of the night where I got to do one more song. I've had my three whiskeys, and I'm going to do something different right now because I've been so inspired lately by the... So inspired by alcohol. I've been so inspired by the whiskeys, the scotches, the bourbons, investigating them, talking about them, doing the unfortunate research by sampling them all the time, that I wrote a song, and I'm gonna sing a song about whiskey, and I hope some of you understand. Hey Dave, love a tune. Yes. When someone says they'd love a tune, that means shut up and start playing. I'm talking too much. So this is a brand new song I wrote. I've been trying to learn piano, obviously, and I've been experimenting with some boogie-woogie piano, so I tried to write my own kind of boogie-woogie version of a song. And I'm reading the lyrics because I just wrote it, so cut me some slack. My wife is still awake. Amal, you gonna come down and make an appearance after this and show everyone the babies? Dean, Ray. Here goes, folks, brand new song. This is called Whiskey Drinking Blues. All right? Well, I woke up this morning, my head is a mess. Drank too much whiskey, I must confess. I got the whiskey drinking blues. I got the whiskey drinking blues. I got the whiskey drinking blues. Good Lord, I don't know what to do. Well, coffee since a quarter to eight. My body is hurting, but my soul appreciates these whiskey drinking blues. I dig these whiskey drinking blues. I love these whiskey drinking blues. Good Lord, I know just what to do. Watch out. Brown just tuned in. Milk it for all you can. Thanks, Dustin. Oh, my wife is creeping down the stairs. Come on down.
I'm in my pajamas.
She's in her pajamas. Thank you, folks. Thank you very much. I can't drink anymore because I'm getting a little tipsy. That tune slaps. Come on over. We got a very slow woman, slow moving woman coming into the scene.
She sees my face.
Can you see?
No, that's,
a boob. That was a boob, folks. That was unintentional. So that's one baby right there. Yep. And that's another baby over there. Whoa. Yeah, but look. See, also me, I've also got this that I've been dealing with. Just from the stress. You gone?
Yeah.
To sleep?
Yeah.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
So that's it, folks. Whisky Hunter, season 5. And based on what you just saw, maybe the last episode ever. Denny, I have a stupid hat on. I also have a stupid hat. but that's okay, because it's Friday, folks. I'm out.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna stay. This is my last song.
Okay.
That's it, folks. The Whisky Hunter. Look, 39 minutes. I ain't gonna get in any trouble tonight. What? And I had an epiphany whilst drinking tonight. I found out why I play drums. Because when you play drums and you have some whiskey or some beer or anything, the drums are so big that when you hit them, you don't miss. You play this freaking piano, the notes are so little, and as you have extra whiskeys, the notes get littler and littler. Thank you for tuning in, folks. Who knows if there'll be another episode? I'm gonna have twins any second now. And the stress. Thank you very much for tuning in. Happy whiskey hunting, folks. Episode 5. Give it up for Glenfiddich, the Balvenie, Monkey Shoulder. Peace, everybody. If you got questions, send them in the comments. I'll try to answer you. Thank you very much for tuning in. Hope to see you next Friday. My wife's dancing with the kids right there.
Cause I'm the whiskey.
Ciao, folks.